Hi, in this video I'd like to show you interactively in Desmos how every trade of change or a line that passes through the function at two different points, how does it become instantaneous rate of change? And what does it mean when we define instantaneous rate of change or derivative in this class as limit as h goes to zero? You may be wondering, why does it have to go to zero? Does it always do that and why? Well, let's take a look. Let's say if we have every trade of change, or this example in Desmos, it's called a secant line. By the way, if you click on these three horizontal lines, you'll see a whole bunch of examples in trigonometry and algebra and calculus. Down here is what will be interesting for us, which is derivative, secant line, tangent line. So we'll explore some other ones later, but secant line is provides us a way to see. Notice how there are sliders right here. Here how we define the slope of the so-called secant line. And hopefully this is familiar to you guys from the homework, but you can actually slide around your A, which is your original point, and you can slide around the H, and you can make it bigger or smaller, or you can move them on the graph if you wanted to. But what's happening when you have average rate of change? So notice how from this point to this point, whether it's in time or whether maybe it's number of items or just whatever interval is given, we can see the function's increasing. But the problem is, as with any average quantity, we don't really see the increases or decreases along the way. So notice how the function's actually changing quite a bit from this point to this point. So it tells us something in the long run, but it doesn't really tell us what's happening before then. Just like with average velocity, you're going 60 miles an hour, doesn't mean necessarily you're going 60 miles an hour the whole way. It's just an average. Well, that's the slope of secant line, or a line that passes through the function a couple of points on an interval. But what if we take the second point and try to make it go closer and closer and closer to the original point? Notice how h is decreasing, or this is how we're actually taking the limit as h goes to zero. So now notice we're getting quite a bit closer to something called a tangent line, or slope of a tangent line actually tells us how the function is increasing or decreasing, or what's happening at a point or at an instant, like instantaneous rate of change. So what is going on right at this point? Well, as it turns out, we cannot actually tell what's happening exactly at that point, because watch if I make h equals exactly zero. Let me try this again. Notice how tangent line or secant line disappears. Why? Because h cannot be exactly zero. You cannot divide by zero, even with the limit. That's why we take a limit. We're trying to approach this value, but not actually equal to it. So the slope is undefined. It disappears. Now let me make h different. So it could be close to zero, but actually may never reach to zero, because tangent line gives us a point. Unfortunately, one point is not enough to compute the slope. So we need a couple of points, but we try to make them as close to one another as possible. If you're dealing with time, you can actually narrow it down to milliseconds if you have precise enough equipment. So you can get really, really close. If you're dealing something like number of items, like you're selling, unfortunately, h equals 1 might be the best you can do. Still notice how it's pretty good. I mean, the function is only differing very slightly in between those two points. So h equals 1, sometimes we're called marginal cost or marginal quantity, marginal profit. We can approximate the cost or revenue or profit of the next item. So sometimes h equals 1 is the best you can do, and that's okay. But sometimes you can do better. But that's why we have limit as h goes to zero, because we're trying to make this a secant line example into a tangent line, or average rate of change into approximate instantaneous rate of change. In fact, when you have a car that's going on a highway and you see how fast you're going right now, usually the car is taking measurements, maybe in small increments, however close they are, and it tells you approximately how fast you're going, but it's still taking measurements continuously, or, you know, every so often. And so you do have maybe a couple or maybe more than a couple of points to approximate how fast you're going at any given point. And that's the same thing with really everything. So derivative approximates how fast something's changing at a given point. But again, the best we can do is approximate it by taking 2 points, or maybe sometimes a whole bunch of points, succession, if I can pronounce it, of points really close to one another, so we can try to tell or approximate the slope of the tangent line, or derivative, or instantaneous rate of change. And that's it.